Have you ever wanted to quickly jump from one sheet to another in Excel? I used to navigate between worksheets by clicking on them like this. But when there's more than a dozen sheets, this is slow. There are much better ways to navigate your Excel workbook, and I'm going to show you my favorites. To get started, we'll look at keyboard shortcuts. Then I'll show you a built-in Excel feature that most people don't know about. This is very handy for quickly navigating between sheets. Finally, I'll show you a few lines of VBA code to help you jump between sheets. We'll add a new keyboard shortcut to use it. I've broken this video into 5 levels, so there's something for everyone. And if you want to get straight into the VBA solution, it starts at level 3. Let's get going! Level 1. Here's a couple of keyboard shortcuts for moving between sheets. Hold Ctrl and page down, or Ctrl and page up to move to the next sheet or the previous sheet. It's like turning the pages of a book, but you can only go forward or backward one sheet at a time. Now, you can also hold Ctrl and Shift and page down, or Ctrl and Shift and page up to select multiple sheets. So watch what happens as I press Ctrl and Shift, then page down, page down, page down. You see I've selected sheets 1 through 4. Just be careful that any changes you make will happen on all your selected sheets, so don't select any more sheets than you need to. Now, these keyboard shortcuts are nice if you have a few sheets to navigate, but they don't work well if you have tons of sheets here. Let's look for a way that handles that better. Level 2. Instead of just moving one sheet at a time, let's jump between sheets. Now, most people who use Excel don't know that there's this feature in the bottom left-hand corner. See these scroll arrows? If you press Ctrl and left-click, you can scroll to the last sheet like this. And if you press Ctrl and left-click on this left arrow, you can scroll to the first sheet like this. Now, notice that it doesn't select the first sheet or the last sheet, it just scrolls there like this. If you want to select, you have to actually click on the first sheet. Now, you can also right-click to see all sheets. This brings up the Activate Sheet dialog box. It's like having a table of contents for your workbook. Double-click on a sheet to jump there, then right-click, and double-click to jump back. Now that's neat, but I think we can do better. Level 3. Let's create a VBA helper. Here's the Activate Sheet dialog box we just saw in Level 2. But there's no keyboard shortcut for it, and I like keyboard shortcuts because they save time. We'll write a VBA macro that shows a menu of workbook tabs. And we'll bind it to the keyboard shortcut Ctrl-J for jump. Then we can show the sheet list using the keyboard and jump to any sheet. First, let's add VBA code to show the workbook tabs pop up. Head to the Developer tab, then click on Visual Basic to open the Visual Basic Editor. Now we'll right-click in this area and insert a module. Next, I'm going to rename this level 3, level underscore 3, and we'll type in SUB for subprocedure, workbook underscore tabs underscore pop up underscore version 1, enter, enter, and we'll enter one line of code, application dot command bars, open parenthesis, bookmarks, workbook tabs, quote marks, close parenthesis, dot show pop-up. Enter. Next, we'll head back into Excel. We want to assign a keyboard shortcut to the VBA macro we just created. So click on Developer, then click on Macros, and then make sure you select the macro we've just created. Hit Options, and press J here. So that means this will assign the shortcut key Ctrl and J. Click OK, close the dialog box. So when I press Ctrl-J, I can use the mouse to select a sheet, left-clicking on it to jump to it. Press Ctrl-J again, I can use the down arrow key and up arrow key to select a sheet, and press Enter to select it. Now make sure that you save this as an Excel macro-enabled workbook, so you keep the VBA code the next time it's opened. One thing to note, we run into a little issue when we have more than 15 sheets in the workbook. So I've added 8 more sheets down here for a total of 20 sheets. When I press Ctrl J to show the tabs menu, you'll see that the sheets after sheet 15 are not listed, and you have to click on More Sheets to show the full scrollable list. How can we improve this so we don't have to click on More Sheets? Level 4. It's time to upgrade our VBA helper. It's going to check how many sheets are in the workbook. If there are fewer than 15 sheets, it will show the quick list. And if there are more than 15 sheets, it will show the scrollable list without us needing to click on More Sheets. Then we'll add the VBA macro to our personal macro workbook so we can access it from any workbook. So the first thing we'll do is choose which pop-up to show. We'll change to VBA, so head into Developer, click on Visual Basic, and on the right here, we'll see the subroutine we wrote in the previous level. We're going to add a comment or two just to clarify what we're doing. And now we're going to add an if-then statement. What this first line says is, if the active workbook's sheets count is greater than 15, then we'll do this first line, which is, application.commandbars, and it's going to look in the workbook tab's command bars, and then it was going to choose the controls called more sheets dot dot dot, and it will execute that. So what that does is show the scrollable list. And if the active workbook sheets count is less than or equal to 15, else we will just show the quick list as a pop-up. And we need one more line, which is end if, to close the construct. Finally, I'm going to change this from version 1 to version 2 and copy it into the personal macro workbook, which I have open down here. I'll copy it into the navigation module, paste it, and then we'll head back into Excel, click on Developer, click on Macros, and remember we have to unassign the previous keyboard shortcut before we assign the new one, so just make sure this is blank. And we'll head back to our personal workbook, and then we'll find the tabs pop-up, click on Options, and use the key J, so Control and J is a keyboard shortcut, to run this macro, hit OK, and then close this dialog box. And now when I press Control J, it shows this activate sheets and a scrollable list because I have 40 worksheets in this workbook. But if I return to the other workbook and delete some of these sheets, now I press Control J, it shows the quick list. So if there are fewer than 15 sheets, it will show quick list like this. And if there are more than 15 sheets, Control J will show the scrollable list like this. Now this is all good, but what happens if I want to jump to a specific cell in a sheet and not just to a sheet? Well, let's say I want to jump between a few specific sheets without scrolling through this whole list of sheets. Let's look at that next. Level 5. So I found this neat little feature that's hidden away in the Formulas tab. It's called the Watch Window. Click here to toggle it on and off. The main purpose of the Watch Window is to help you keep an eye on the value and formula of different cells. But we're going to use it for jumping between sheets. Using the watch window is like adding bookmarks in your browser or your favorite book. You can add a watch for each location you want to jump to. So in this case, I'm going to add a watch to H5 on sheet 2, click on Add, then add another watch to sheet 1, H5, and click Add. Then you double click on the row to jump to that location. Here, I'll double click on sheet 1 to jump to sheet 1, and then I'll double click on the row for sheet 2 to jump back to sheet 2. So the beauty of this is you can pick specific cells to jump to, and you don't have to scroll through a long list of all your sheets to find your favorites. Now here's a pro tip. You can dock the watch window in different locations, either up here, or on the left, and then resize it to suit your working style. You now have 5 tools at your disposal for jumping between sheets. Now the truth is that Excel is full of useful tools and features that 99% of users never use. And that's why I love making these videos for you. I want to open your eyes to what's possible with the right know-how. So if you like learning about Excel, please subscribe to my channel to make sure you get all my latest videos. And I hope you see that learning Excel VBA can be both fun and useful. Plus, check the video description below for more awesome Excel and VBA resources. And I'll see you soon. Happy excelling!